Good evening, America. Welcome to Rivaldo. Tonight, I plan to show you a group of people who thrive on satanic pleasure. A group of people who, without mercy, hurt and harass the many. A group of people who, on the WSU campus alone, have suppressed the will of thousands. Who are these horrific people? What is this underground cult? The answers to these questions, as I reveal WSU's parking services as Satan's secret underground, tonight on Rivaldo. Welcome back. First, before we go on, a word of warning. I'd like to say that what you're going to see tonight is very real, and it is not pretty. It may make you sick. It may make you want to vote Republican. But it's very true. So I urge those of you who have children who do not have their driver's licenses to please take them out of the room. Tonight, we have a group of people who have been harassed by these ticket-toting disciples of Lucifer, these brothers of Beelzebub. They have been harmed, and they're ready to tell their stories here tonight. But first, we have our first guest here tonight. Her name is Lucy, a lovely young woman. Lucy, what is your story?
Well, I was at the bookie, and I was parked out front, you know, by the parking meters, and I went to put my money in the meter, and I turned the dial, and I said I had a half an hour left, and I was only in there for 15 minutes, not more. And when I came out, there were...
Lucy, it's okay. You can tell your story. You're among friends.
There were two tickets on my windshield, and they were $10 apiece.
That is just one of the horrific stories that we have tonight. Little Timmy has felt the damage these people have handed out. Here is Timmy's drawing and his story.
My mommy, those are tears in her eyes, and I am there, and she can't give me Transformers because she has to pay a ticket. I am crying too.
Terrible. I believe we have a caller. Where are you calling from, sir?
I'm calling from Colfax, Washington.
And what do you think of this travesty?
Well, I'm just saying I don't think it's as bad as it seems.
So you condone all of this? That's what you're saying?
Mister, I've seen some of those drivers, and they like it. They park that way on purpose. They're all weirdos. They park like that on purpose.
So you're actually one of these satanic monsters. You make me sick. Get the hell off my line.
I'm only saying they're getting what's coming to them. They're all weirdos.
George, can we cut this guy off, please? Thank you. Right now, we have a young man by the name of Russ. Russ is not his real name. Russ used to work for parking services, and tonight he's here to tell us our story. Russ, what was it like working on the inside?
Well, Rivaldo, at the time, I thought it was fun. I mean, after a day of ticketing, we'd all tell stories and swap stories about all the dirty tricks we played on people to get them tickets. I was caught up in the good times. I did not see the hell that was around me.
So, Russ, how did you become one of these pathetic monsters?
Basically, Rivaldo, I was a shallow person. An introvert. A nobody. I only did this so I could gain some status. When I told the other guys at the services all the tricks I'd played and everything, I felt looked up to. But I realized it was a lower me. I was scum, and I admit it.
So how did you escape this self-made hell, this constant pit of despair, this sect of shame?
Well, I was on my way home from work, and I came up to my car, and I noticed something was wrong. I mean, I'd parked right, and I was in the right stall, but I'd been ticketed. $25 ticket for no snow tires. And it was May. I realized the injustice. I realized the inhumanity. I realized I had ticketed myself.
So, that is the story for tonight. I hope you've all learned something. I know I have, but I always learn everything. So I look forward to the day that this is only a blurry smudge, a dark spot on our history, and I'm sure one day it will be. Please, join me next week, but remember, what you might see is not pretty. It's very real. It's disgusting. Please take the children out of the room, and good night.
Fortune seems to follow me everywhere I go. Today I was told that I'll be starring with Raymond Burr in a brand new made-for-TV movie called Requiem for an Overweight. Anyway, I'm glad you all liked it. My name is Terrence Brown. I'm your host for Live at 8, and that gives you all one more good reason to... Okay, well, we'll just pass on to new stuff. Well, you know, you may not know this, but Burger King finally opened up in Pullman, and I feel it's just in the nick of time. It now gives all those fine arts majors an assurance that they'll get a job after graduating. And on the international front, I hear that a famous toy company in Taiwan is now manufacturing a Liberace doll. Now, unfortunately, sales haven't been that good. It seems nobody wants to blow them up. I wish my brother George was here. And we all know that the Cougars are facing the University of Washington next month for the Apple Cup. Evidently, the two head coaches have a bet on the side. It seems that whoever loses the game has to watch Booth Gardner's kids for a weekend. You know, if you're kind of fed up with my affair today, tonight on CBS, it's Halloween is Grinch Night, and a delightful retelling of the classic Dr. Seuss tale. The evil Grinch gains revenge when he sets fire to Whoville, claiming the lives of all its inhabitants. That's tawdry family affair. In a survey of Washington State students today, 20% of those polled thought that Senate candidate Mike Lowry had no teeth. Mike Lowry, you know, he's got that kind of deliverance look. Hey, vote for me. Or, well, first, squeal like a pig. And all of a sudden, it's very warm in here, isn't it? Evidently, presidential candidates Mike Dukakis and George Bush had another debate in a small Illinois town. Now, someone asked Dukakis, who was responsible for all this political mudslinging? Dukakis said, well, it was Bush. He started it all. To which Bush replied, I know you are, but what am I? These are men of action, tomorrow's leaders, today's surprise. Hey, you know, it's Halloween. And, you know, most of you, I can tell, most of you are saying yourselves right now, hey, I wonder what my favorite celebrity's tombstone looks like. Well, it just so happens we got some right now. Well, speaking of Liberace, I'm sure you've been wondering about Liberace. His happens to say, ivory whites weren't the only things I tickled. And Elvis, you know, there's a big controversy about Elvis. Well, this is what it says. I'm dead, for Christ's sakes. Now leave me alone. Okay, oh, Jimi Hendrix, Seattle native and big star. Excuse me while I kiss the dirt. Oh, okay. I can see this is going nowhere. Oh, finally, though, Dan Quayle. His says, I'm not dead, but I'm sure qualified to be. Thank you, Doug Jackson. Later on, CBS again, Garfield's Halloween Adventure. Garfield dresses up as a vampire and goes trick-or-treating, only to be eventually hit by a milk truck! Great. So ends my entertainment career. Anyway, Tonight is a show full of wacky and madcap stuff. We visited a haunted house, we have some Halloween tips for kids, and we visit a family suffering some... Oh, come on. Unbelievable. I'm part of this family. A family suffering from severe neural shutdown. Come back and join us. We got plenty more. Come back.
Hey, friends. Does gardening really get your goat? Do you have those weeding woes? Do dandelions have you down in the dumps? If so, then I have the perfect solution. Let me introduce you to the Garden Weasel. This is Leonard, also known as the Garden Weasel. Leonard is a horticulture major at the University of Washington. The Garden Weasel can take your garden from blecky to beautiful in just 1 week's time. Let's take a look at the Garden Weasel in action. The Garden Weasel comes with an array of attachments, is easy to clean, easy to feed, and is totally portable. Now, how can you get your handy and affordable Garden Weasel? It's simple. Just send check or money order to The Garden Weasel, 2969 University Way Northeast, Seattle, Washington, 98125. Once we receive your check, we'll send Leonard out to your house within 6 to 8 weeks, depending on his class schedule. The Garden Weasel. Order yours today.
Delicious. Come try Sella's mouth-watering Italian calzonian pizza, made fresh daily from the very best toppings and smothered with real mozzarella cheese, formed into a turnover and baked to perfection. Come experience the taste that many already have for a price that won't leave your pockets empty. Sella's calzonian pizza, Pullman's newest Italian dining experience, conveniently located across the street from the Stevenson Complex. For delivery, call 334-1895.
The chromosomes come together and... Oh, no, wait. Who cares what chromosomes do? Who cares about fission and sexual reproduction? Well, sexual reproduction. Yeah. Oh, well, anyway. When would I ever use this stuff? I'll just kind of slip this in here. There, all set.
Good luck, Frederick!
Well, we've reviewed your resume and your credentials, and everything seems to be in order. Except, tell me, Mr. Nelson, when two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, what is true of the interior angles?
Well, what kind of question is that? This job doesn't require...
I take it you don't know the answer.
Well, give me an example of onomatopoeia.
On a who?
Onomatopoeia. It's a writing style used in poetry.
See, Sam, sit in
no,
the...
No, sorry, that's alliteration.
Oh, well, wait a minute.
In what year did Eli Whitney perfect the cotton gin?
18...
Sorry, that's incorrect.
In woodshop, it is important to make only what cut on a radial arm saw?
What?
Wrong.
According to the Book of Facts, located in your high school's reference section of the library, who is the true master of the pan flute?
Zamfir?
Well, that's correct. What is the true of an isosceles triangle?
Huh? Well, I...
What are the four basic food groups?
I can't take anymore. I just can't...
According to your P.E. folk dance unit,
yes?
Where did the Teton Mountain Stomp originate?
What?
You know... Give me the five steps in threading a bobbin for a sewing machine.
What are the five main steps of meiosis in biology?
I can't take anymore. I just can't take anymore. Where's somebody like me going to get a job with my meager qualifications?
Well, I hear the Daily Evergreen is looking for a new spring editor.
Yes, it's once again time for ghosts, ghouls, and goblins. And no, I'm not talking about one of David Crosby's drug-induced hallucinations. I'm talking about Halloween. And this week, we took a trip to a real haunted house. So cuddle up real close and watch.
Halloween is fast approaching, and we decided to take a look at some very scary places. No, I'm not talking about the headquarters of parking services or Jamie Farr's nose. Our first stop today is the famed McConnell Mansion in Moscow. Built in 1886, the McConnell Mansion served as a love nest for many dignitaries, including playwright Oscar Wilde and circus stars Buffy and Tina, the amazing mulatto twins. Many famous dead people have signed the ledger here at the mansion. Here are but a few. So we've got Clark Gable, Jimi Hendrix was here. What's this? Basketball coach Len Stevens? Rumor has it that legendary comedian W.C. Fields once dined in this very room. You can hear him grunt and moan at this moment.
What do you mean, 50 pounds and chop it fine? Sit it down there and get out.
The portrait over the fireplace is that of General Angus McConnell. He died a stark raving lunatic while trying to comb the flies from his beard. Legend has it that the king of ragtime music, Scott Joplin, spent the night here in 1899. He became so intoxicated during his stay that he soaked the maple leaf rag in kerosene and set himself on fire. We're now upstairs at the McConnell Mansion Chamber of Horrors. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the Doc Severance and Tapestry Collection. Many Moscow legends are said to haunt McConnell Mansion. This is Moscow P. Coltrane, Moscow's first sheriff. He was eventually run out of town for breaking wind during a Catholic mass. Here's Harold Droopy McBain, the first man ever to die by his own feet. He would while away the hours entertaining local children by imitating a department store mannequin. And finally, here's former Moscow Mayor Tommy Shivers, beloved civic leader. He's pictured here displaying one of the fine projects he made during his stay at the Idaho State Prison.
You want to see something really scary? Take a look at this. It's a senior citizen slot machine, complete with prunes and pictures of singer Wayne Newton in a karate outfit. There's an attic full of ghostly treasures here at McConnell Mansion. Why don't we step on up the stairs and take a look? Ugh. The stairs getting more narrow, am I getting fatter? Ugh.
There are numerous haunted children's publications in this attic. My Weekly Reader, 1936. Here is another new train, It will run from Chicago to St. Louis, unless it's operated by Amtrak, in which case it will derail and burn outside of Cleveland. This house was built on a giant redwood tree. The Indians made the house and lived in it for hundreds of years. The new owners are upset. It seems the Indians neglected to clean up when they moved out. This little polar bear was born in the Detroit Zoo. This is the first time he has been outdoors. He's carrying a large amount of cash. Detroit is dangerous at night. The attic is full of haunted toys from yesteryear. And over here are the most diabolical of them all. Kitty and Bertha, the Jimmy Swaggart action figures. These snowshoes were once owned by one of the Mills brothers. Legend has it that on Halloween night, you can hear them doing a sand dance. Well, I'm heading on down to the basement here at the McConnell Mansion. You know, legend has it that there's a network of tunnels that run from the basement here to all corners of the Palouse. So if you hear something milling around under your floorboards late at night, it'll probably be me, looking for a public restroom. Happy Halloween.
I have redeemed myself. We'll be back with plenty more mirth and whimsy. Come on back. Come on.
You know, the girls may like my tight blue jeans, and an athletic supporter may protect me from harm. But you know, these things can trap tiny bacteria and germs, which can cause odor. That's why I use Masculine Mist. Masculine Mist time release formula allows me to smell as fresh as a woman and as macho as a man. And with Masculine Mist, I can ride horseback, swim, or run barefoot through a field. All the things I normally do. And Masculine Mist has this handy applicator without the use of unsightly belts or pins. And of course, it has wings. Oh yes, it has wings. So go out and buy your Masculine Mist today, because so much is riding on your crotch.
Without the Z. KUGR 95.1 FM. Pullman's Choice Rock and Roll.
Hi, Dad. Hi, Mom. How are you?
Ghost your father.
Hi, Dad. How's Mom?
Well, now, son, I hardly think that's any of your business. Go play with your toys.
But I gave all my toys away because the neighbor kids called me a dope.
Well, go play with yourself, then.
Ah! Dad, what's that?
Ah! What is that? Martha, what is that?
Ah! Oh, I noticed that the other day. You know, it's been here since we've been here. Why don't you move it, Harv?
Well, I would. Don't you think I'd burn my hands on it? I mean, maybe it's radioactive. You never know.
Well, don't be silly. If it were radioactive, it would be in by the refrigerator.
Oh, of course it would. Jeez, how dopey of me. God, son, go get me my golf clubs, would you? What for? Now, don't you talk back to me like that, young man, and don't make me talk back to you. Or I'll slap your mother till she can't see straight. Now go on in and get me my axe handle.
But what do you need the bar stool for?
I didn't say bar stool. I said meat grinder. Now move or I'll have to go get it myself. And I won't come back either.
Don't talk to your daughter that way or she'll kick the dog and the whole neighborhood will know that you can't play tennis.
Oh, jeez. I'll get that. No!
Goodbye? Oh, yes, this is the dope residence. Who would I vote for if the elections were today? Dan Quayle. He's not running for president. Well, I don't know very much about politics. Neither does Dan Quayle. I'm sorry. I really don't know much about politics. That's probably why I'd vote for him for prime minister. Thank you for your time. Hello.
Who was that in the toaster, honey?
Dan Quayle.
What's that bird doing in our toaster?
We want to know something about erections. And if we hang me today.
Well, now, honey, next time someone calls up on the phone and asks you that question, you just look them right in the eye and say no.
Oh, what's that?
Well, it's just Junior, honey.
Say hi, Junior.
What is that?
It's your golf clubs, Dad.
No, son. It's just something big and much broader than my golf clubs. I don't know what that is. Well, go get me my meat grinder, would you?
But that's upstairs in the basement.
Upstairs in the basement? Son, the basement is out in the garage.
I'm sorry, but that's my room.
Your
stop
room?
Stuffing our potatoes for dinner tonight.
No.
Yes. Honey, will you go get me the Cuisinart? I want to see what's on television tonight.
I can't. I cut up all the carrots in the TV guide.
Oh, no. Son, have you been stuffing your pants again?
Yeah, with lima beans.
What'd you go and do a thing like that for? There's people starving in India.
Because the lawnmower was on.
Oh, right, snakes. I told you not to leave that darn thing on.
Who took my stove?
Stove? Stove?
Ah, what's that?
Oh, wait, I know. It's a wall. It's a wall, everybody.
It's a wall.
Oh, it's a wall.
Dad, your toaster's getting warm.
It's supposed to be, son. Don't worry.
Oh, wall.
You know, childhood memories of Halloween are fond ones for me. Trick-or-treating, the costumes, apples with razor blades in them. Well, here at Live at 8, we're concerned about today's youth. So we put together some helpful Halloween tips for our kids. Watch carefully. You may learn something.
It's important for kids to build self-esteem. One way is to portray their heroes for Halloween. This lucky youngster is going as Olympic diving star Greg Louganis. One of the hottest costumes this Halloween season is the flammable tomboy outfit. A word of caution, don't stand near comedian George Burns when he lights up a stogie. When making your Halloween plans, be sure to stay away from the home of syndicated columnist Carl Rowan. On the same note, be sure to rule out felony trespass for an evening's entertainment. If trick-or-treating isn't your bag, why not take a trip down to Pullman Raceway for the first annual Reggie Rogers Involuntary Manslaughter Derby?
Here, Mr. Polanski, please accept this small trinket in exchange for your personal services.
Rule number 7. This is a kid. This is a chicken. Only chickens eat treats from the hands of strangers. Don't be a chicken. If you're going to be hallucinating on LSD, stay away from the racetrack and the specter of Willie Shoemaker. A rule of thumb for our Greek friends, if one of your frat brothers drinks too much, try this, the Woody Hayes maneuver. And again, I can't stress this enough. Always check your closet for the bodies of male intruders. No one can accuse President Reagan of not getting gussied up for Halloween. In fact, in 1942, he dressed as the lovable space alien E.T. Trick or treat, Tojo. And one final Live at 8 Halloween tip for kids.
Know your enemy, but also know your friend.
Hey, you're cute. Want to play in my Oval Office?
Thanks a lot. That's all the time we have for this week. We'll see you next week. Bye-bye and bye bonds. Bye-bye.
People who on the WSU campus alone have suppressed the will of thousands. Who are these horrific people? What is this underground cult? The answers to these questions as I reveal WSU's parking services as Satan's secret underground. Tonight on Rivaldo. Welcome back. First, before we go on, a word of warning. I'd like to say that what you're going to see tonight is very real, and it is not pretty. It may make you sick. It may make you want to vote Republican. But it's very true. So I urge those of you who have children who do not have their driver's licenses to please take them out of the room. Tonight, we have a group of people who have been harassed by these ticket-toting disciples of Lucifer, these brothers of Beelzebub. They have been harmed, and they're ready to tell their stories here tonight. But first, we have our first guest here tonight. Her name is Lucy, a lovely young woman. Lucy, what is your story?
Well, I was at the bookie, and I was parked out front, you know, by the parking meters, and I went to put my money in the meter, and I turned the dial, and I said I had a half an hour left, and I was only in there for 15 minutes, not more, and when I came out, there were...
Lucy, it's okay. You can tell your story. You're among friends.
There were two tickets on my windshield, and they were $10 apiece!
That is just one of the horrific stories that we have tonight. Little Timmy has felt the damage these people have handed out. Here is Timmy's drawing and his story.
My mommy, those are tears in her eyes, and I am there, and she can't give me Transformers because she has to pay a ticket. I am crying too.
Terrible. I believe we have a caller. Where are you calling from, sir?
I'm calling from Colfax, Washington.
And what do you think of this travesty?
Well, I'm just saying I don't think it's as bad as it seems.
So you condone all of this, that's what you're saying?
Mister, I've seen some of those drivers, and they like it. They park that way on purpose. They're all weirdos. They park like that on purpose.
So you're actually one of these satanic monsters. You make me sick. Get the hell off my line.
I'm only saying they're getting what's coming to them. They're all weirdos.
George, can we cut this guy off, please? Thank you. Right now, we have a young man by the name of Russ. Russ is not his real name.
What's that? Oh, wait, I know. It's a wall. It's a wall, everybody.
It's a wall.
It's a wall.
Dad, your toaster's getting warm.
It's supposed to be, son. Don't worry. Oh, oh, oh.
You know, childhood memories of Halloween are fond ones for me. Trick-or-treating, the costumes, apples with razor blades in them. Well, here at Live at 8, we're concerned about today's youth. So we put together some helpful Halloween tips for our kids. Watch carefully. You may learn something.
It's important for kids to build self-esteem. One way is to portray their heroes for Halloween. This lucky youngster is going as Olympic diving star Greg Louganis. One of the hottest costumes this Halloween season is the flammable tomboy outfit. A word of caution, don't stand near comedian George Burns when he lights up a stogie. When making your Halloween plans, be sure to stay away from the home of syndicated columnist Carl Rowan. On the same note, be sure to rule out felony trespass for an evening's entertainment. If trick-or-treating isn't your bag, why not take a trip down to Pullman Raceway for the first annual Reggie Rogers Involuntary Manslaughter Derby?
Here, Mr. Polanski, please accept this small trinket in exchange for your personal services.
Rule number 7. This is a kid. This is a chicken. Only chickens eat treats from the hands of strangers. Don't be a chicken. If you're going to be hallucinating on LSD, stay away from the racetrack and the specter of Willie Shoemaker. A rule of thumb for our Greek friends, if one of your frat brothers drinks too much, try this. The Woody Hayes maneuver. And again, I can't stress this enough. Always check your closet for the bodies of male intruders. No one can accuse President Reagan of not getting gussied up for Halloween. In fact, in 1942, he dressed as the lovable space alien E.T. Trick or treat, Tojo. And one final Live at 8 Halloween tip for kids.
Know your enemy, but also know your friend.
Hey, you're cute. Want to play in my Oval Office?
Well, we've reviewed your resume and your credentials, and everything seems to be in order. Except, tell me, Mr. Nelson, when two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, what is true of the interior angles?
Well, what kind of question is that? This job doesn't
require I take it you don't know the answer.
Well,
give me an example of onomatopoeia.
On a who?
Onomatopoeia. It's a writing style used in poetry.
Oh, see, Sam, sit,
and... No, the... sorry, that's alliteration.
Oh, well, wait a minute.
In what year did Eli Whitney perfect the cotton gin?
18...
Sorry, that's incorrect. In woodshop, it is important to make only what cut on a radial arm saw?
What?
Wrong.
According to the Book of Facts, located in your high school's reference section of the library, who is the true master of the pan flute?
Zamfir?
Well, that's correct.
What is the true of an isosceles triangle?
Huh? Well,
what are the four basic food groups?
I can't take anymore. I just can't...
According to your P.E. folk dance unit,
yes?
Where did the Teton Mountain Stomp originate?
What?
You know... Give me the five steps in threading a bobbin for a sewing machine.
What are the five main steps of meiosis in biology?
I can't take anymore. I just can't take anymore. Where's somebody like me going to get a job with my meager qualifications?
Well, I hear the Daily Evergreen is looking for a new spring editor.
Yes, it's once again time for ghosts, ghouls, and goblins. And no, I'm not talking about one of David Crosby's drug-induced hallucinations. I'm talking about Halloween. And this week, we took a trip to a real haunted house. So cuddle up real close and watch.
Halloween is fast approaching, and we decided to take a look at some very scary places. No, I'm not talking about the headquarters of parking services or Jamie Farr's nose. Our first stop today is the famed McConnell Mansion in Moscow. Built in 1886, the McConnell Mansion served as a love nest for many dignitaries, including playwright Oscar Wilde and circus stars Buffy and Tina, the amazing mulatto twins. Many famous dead people have signed the ledger here at the mansion. Here are but a few. So we've got Clark Gable, Jimi Hendrix was here.
Fortune seems to follow me everywhere I go. Today I was told that I'll be starring with Raymond Burr in a brand new made-for-TV movie called Requiem for an Overweight. Anyway, I'm glad you all liked it. My name is Terrence Brown. I'm your host for Live at 8, and that gives you all one more good reason to... Okay, well, we'll just pass on to new stuff. Well, you know, you may not know this, but Burger King finally opened up in Pullman, and I feel assisted in the nick of time. It now gives all those fine arts majors an assurance that they'll get a job after graduating. And on the international front, I hear that a famous toy company in Taiwan is now manufacturing a Liberace doll. Now, unfortunately, sales haven't been that good. It seems nobody wants to blow them up. I wish my brother George was here. And we all know that the Cougars are facing the University of Washington next month for the Apple Cup. Evidently, the two head coaches have a bet on the side. It seems that whoever loses the game has to watch Booth Gardner's kids for a weekend. You know, if you're kind of fed up with my affair today, tonight on CBS, it's Halloween is Grinch Night, and a delightful retelling of the classic Dr. Seuss tale, the evil Grinch gains revenge when he sets fire to Whoville, claiming the lives of all its inhabitants. That's tawdry family affair. In a survey of Washington State students today, 20% of those polled thought that Senate candidate Mike Lowry had no teeth. Mike Lowry, you know, he's got that kind of deliverance look. Hey, vote for me. Or, well, first, squeal like a pig. And all of a sudden, it's very warm in here, isn't it? Evidently, presidential candidates Mike Dukakis and George Bush had another debate in a small Illinois town. Now, someone asked Dukakis, who was responsible for all this political mudslinging? Dukakis said, well, it was Bush. He started it all. To which Bush replied, I know you are, but what am I? These are men of action, tomorrow's leaders, today's surprise. And you know, it's Halloween, and you know, most of you, I can tell, most of you are saying yourselves right now, hey, I wonder what my favorite celebrity's tombstone looks like. Well, it just so happens we got...
I realize the injustice. I realize the inhumanity. I realize I had ticketed myself.
So, that is the story for tonight. I hope you've all learned something. I know I have, but I always learn everything. So I look forward to the day that this is only a blurry smudge, a dark spot on our history, and I'm sure one day it will be. Please, join me next week, but remember, what you might see is not pretty. It's very real. It's disgusting. Please take the children out of the room, and good night.
Seems to follow me everywhere I go. Today I was told that I'll be starring with Raymond Burr in a brand new made-for-TV movie called Requiem for an Overweight. Anyway, I'm glad you all liked it. My name is Terrence Brown. I'm your host for Live at 8, and that gives you all one more good reason to... Okay, well, we'll just pass on to new stuff. Well, you know, you may not know this, but Burger King finally opened up in Pullman, and I feel assisted in the nick of time. It now gives all those fine arts majors an assurance that they'll get a job after graduating. And on the international front, I hear that a famous toy company in Taiwan is now manufacturing a Liberace doll. Now, unfortunately, sales haven't been that good. It seems nobody wants to blow them up. I wish my brother George was here. And we all know that the Cougars are facing the University of Washington next month for the Apple Cup. Evidently, the two head coaches have a bet on the side. It seems that whoever loses the game has to follow me everywhere I go. Today, I was told that I'll be starring with Raymond Burr in a brand new made-for-TV movie called Requiem for an Overweight. Anyway, I'm glad you all liked it. My name is Terrence Brown. I'm your host for Live at 8, and that gives you all one more good reason to... Just pass on to new stuff. Well, you know, you may not know this, but Burger King finally opened up in Pullman, and I feel it's just in the nick of time. It now gives all those fine arts majors an assurance that they'll get a job after graduating. And on the international front, I hear that a famous toy company in Taiwan is now manufacturing a Liberace doll. Now, unfortunately, sales haven't been that good. It seems nobody wants to blow them up. I wish my brother George was here. And we all know that the Cougars are facing the University of Washington next month for the Apple Cup. Evidently, the two head coaches have a bet on the side. It seems that whoever loses the game has to watch Booth Gardner's kids for a weekend. You know, if you're kind of fed up with my fare today, tonight on CBS, it's Halloween is Grinch Night, and a delightful retelling of the classic Dr. Seuss tale. The evil Grinch gains revenge when he sets fire to Whoville, claiming the lives of all its inhabitants. That's tawdry family fare. In a survey of Washington State students today, 20% of those polled thought that Senate candidate Mike Lowry had no teeth. Mike Lowry, you know, he's got that kind of deliverance look. Hey, vote for me. Or, well, first, squeal like a pig. And all of a sudden, it's very warm in here, isn't it? Evidently, presidential candidates Mike Dukakis and George Bush had another debate in a small Illinois town. Now, someone asked Dukakis, who was responsible for all this political mudslinging? Dukakis said, well, it was Bush. He started it all. To which Bush replied, I know you are, but what am I? These are men of action. Tomorrow's leaders, today's surprise. And you know, it's Halloween, and you know, most of you, I can tell, most of you are saying yourselves right now, hey, I wonder what my favorite celebrity's tombstone looks like. Well, it just so happens we got some right now. Well, speaking of Liberace, I'm sure you've been wondering about Liberace. His happens to say, ivory whites weren't the only things I tickled. And Elvis, you know, there's a big controversy about Elvis. Well, this is what it says. I'm dead, for Christ's sakes. Now leave me alone. Okay. Oh, Jimi Hendrix, Seattle native and big star. Excuse me.
The four basic food groups.
I can't take anymore. I just can't.
According to your P.E. folk dance unit,
yes?
Where did the Teton Mountain Stomp originate?
What?
You know. Give me the five steps in threading a bobbin for a sewing machine.
What are the five main steps of meiosis in biology?
I can't take anymore. I just can't take anymore. Where's somebody like me going to get a job with my meager qualifications?
Well, I hear the Daily Evergreen is looking for a new spring editor. Yes, it's once again time for ghosts, ghouls, and goblins. And no, I'm not talking about one of David Crosby's drug-induced hallucinations. I'm talking about Halloween. And this week, we took a trip to a real haunted house. So cuddle up real close and watch.
Halloween is fast approaching, and we decided to take a look at some very scary places. No, I'm not talking about the headquarters of parking services or Jamie Farr's nose. Our first stop today is the famed McConnell Mansion in Moscow. Built in 1886, the McConnell Mansion served as a love nest for many dignitaries, including playwright Oscar Wilde and circus stars Buffy and Tina, the amazing mulatto twins. Many famous dead people have signed the ledger here at the mansion, Here are but a few. So we've got Clark Gable. Jimi Hendrix was here. What's this? Basketball coach Len Stevens? Rumor has it that legendary comedian W.C. Fields once dined in this very room. You can hear him grunt and moan at this moment.
What do you mean, 50 pounds and chop it fine? Put it down there and get out.
The portrait over the fireplace is that of General Angus McConnell. He died a stark raving lunatic while trying to comb the flies from his beard. Legend has it that the king of ragtime music, Scott Joplin, spent the night here in 1899. He became so intoxicated during his stay that he soaked the maple leaf rag in kerosene and set himself on fire. We're now upstairs at the McConnell Mansion Chamber of Horrors. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the Doc Severinsen